poverty, anger, lust, unforgiveness. The curse is broken.
The enemy is trying to make me believe that my past is who I am, that the mistakes I've made from yesterday is all that I would ever be.
They looked at my family and said I'd be nothing.
They told me I would be nothing. Nobody in my family ever was.
This is what they said.
They said, you're just like your mama, just like your daddy. Never amounted to anything.
But I couldn't accept that.
But that's not me.
It's not who I am.
It's not who I am.
God gave me a promise.
God gave me a promise. On that I stand.
So today,
the curse is broken.
I've made some mistakes, but
my past can't hold.
I felt defeated, but I know now
I'm more than a conqueror.
I read his word and it's what he told me.
That's what he told me.
So I'm so glad that the curse is broken.
The curse is broken.
I can declare that my body's healed.
My body's healed.
You've got to know that the devil,
the devil's a lie.
And I'm free today because it's in his will.
It's in his will.
Thank you, Jesus. The enemy.
The enemy is trying to make me believe
my past.
That my past is who I am.
That every mistake I made,
mistakes I made from yesterday,
certain struggles have been in my family, but listen, it's not me.
It's not who I am.
Oh, God gave me a promise.
God gave me a promise.
And that's what I'm standing on today. So somebody just lift your hands and say,
the curse is broken.
The curse is broken. And I know now that my past, I'm so grateful, God, that I'm more than a conqueror. What my mother struggled with, what my father struggled with, it stops with
that's
me. That's what you told me. Oh, that's right. The curse is broken.
The curse is broken.
Lay your hands on yourself and say, my body's healed. Don't listen to the enemy because the devil, he's a liar. He can't change what's in God's will. It's come on, Todd, help me. Say the mistake.
The mistake.
It's not who I am.
It's not who I am.
The lies.
The lies they told.
It's not who I am.
It's not who I am.
My past.
My past. It's not who I am.
Today the curse.
The curse is broken in my life.
The abortion.
The abortion.
I regret it.
It's not who I am.
It's not who I am.
The misfortune you went
through. The misfortune.
It's not who I am.
It's not who I am.
The disease, oh no.
The disease.
That's not who you are.
It's not who I am.
The curse is broken.
The curse is broken.
Come on, say I'm healed. Because every curse is
working in my life.
Hallelujah. You're still calling my name. Although I've sinned, you said, Adam, where art thou? Oh, Jesus, you're still calling my name. Thank you, Jesus. My name. God bless you. Fellowship with five persons close by you. Shake their hands. Greet them. Bless them. And if you don't have anything to tell them God is still calling your name. God is still calling your name. If you listen closely, you'll hear He's calling your name. If you listen closely, you will hear your name. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory to Jesus. Hallelujah. Oh my God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory to Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Calling my name. Praise the Lord. Revelations chapter 1. Revelation chapter 1. From verse 3 we find these words. Blessed is he that readeth, and they that hear the words of this prophecy, and keep those things which are written therein, for the time is at hand. John, to the seven churches which are in Asia, grace be unto you and peace from him which is and was and which is to come, and from the seven spirits which are before his throne, and from Jesus Christ, who is a faithful witness and the first begotten of the dead and the prince of the kings of the earth. Unto him that loved us and washed us from our sins in his own blood, and hath made us kings and priests unto God and his Father, to him be glory and dominion forever and ever. Amen. Behold, he cometh with clouds, and every eye shall see him, and they also which pierced him. And all kindreds of the earth shall wail because of him. Even so, amen. I am Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the ending, saith the Lord, which is, and which was, and which is to come, the Almighty. I, John, who also am your brother and companion in tribulation and in the kingdom and patience of Jesus Christ, was in the isle that is called Patmos for the word of God, for the testimony of Jesus Christ. I was in the Spirit on the Lord's day, and I heard behind me a great voice as of a trumpet saying, I am Alpha and Omega, the first and the last. And what thou seest, write in a book, and send it unto the seven churches which are in Asia, unto Ephesus, and unto Smyrna, and unto Pergamos, and unto Thyatira, and unto Sardis, and unto Philadelphia, and unto Laodicea. Heavenly Father, we ask you now to breathe upon us as we proclaim the word of God. Send the anointing of your Spirit upon us, we pray thee. Lord God, will you arise for us and scatter all our enemies? Grant, O Lord, that salvation will come to the lost, healing to those who are sick, reclamation to those who have strayed from the path, strength and empowerment for the believers. And above all, may your name be honored and glorified. We pray in Jesus' name. Everybody shout amen. I want to preach to you on this theme this morning, Jesus Christ, God's package to mankind. Jesus Christ, God's package. And in that package, you have everything that you'll ever need, both for time and eternity. There is nothing lacking in God's package, which is Jesus Christ. When persons go to supermarket these days or markets, because of the economic crisis and the shortage and money to spend and all of that, they will have to prioritize the items that they purchase. And some will be coming home from the market disappointed because they had to leave some important things behind. Some leave from the supermarket the very same, disheartened and disappointed, because they could not fill the trolley, the basket, the bags as they really wanted because of scarcity of fund. But when you receive God's package, who is the Lord Jesus Christ, hallelujah, there is nothing that is missing from that package. Everything that you need, oh praise the name of Jesus, ought to be found in the man Christ Jesus. Lift your hand and give him praise here. It has been said that you can give without love, but you cannot love without give. If you love, you are going to demonstrate your love through giving. The golden text of the Bible, John 3:16, tells us, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. I love verse 17. It says, for God sent not his Son into the world to condemn the world, but that the world through him might be saved. All those who are saved through Jesus Christ's precious blood, lift your hand and say, thank God I am saved. Hallelujah. So God's love for mankind has been fully expressed, fully demonstrated, fully manifested, fully exemplified in the package that is sent to us, which is none other than Jesus Christ. When I thought of it, I said, Jesus Christ is the everything and more package. He is the everything and more package, because all that you need now, you can find. All that you need tomorrow, you will find. All that you need through time and into eternity, at the time and at the point of your need, God can supply that need. And that need is supplied through the riches of Christ. Amen. In glory. Can you say amen? Amen. Paul declares him to be the only person who can supply every need. There is absolutely no other human being on earth, no institution on earth, who can supply fully the needs of every human being. But Paul declares him in Philippians 4:19 as the only one who can supply all our needs. He says, but my God. Lay your hand on the person beside you and tell them, my God. Hallelujah. These days we have got to make sure that we identify our God, because there are all kinds of gods around the place. But my God, the eternal God, Paul said, he shall supply all of your needs according to his riches in glory by Christ Jesus. Give him praise, somebody. Hallelujah. He supplies them all. And not only that, he supplies all the need, but Jesus is the only person
who can do both that which is thinkable and that which is unthinkable. Amen. The word of God says in Ephesians 3 and verse 20, he is able to do exceeding abundantly above that which you may ask, that which you may think, according to the power that works in us. If you can think it, God can do it. And when you cannot think it, God can still do it for you. Somebody praise the great God of heaven today. Hallelujah. Think it, he will do it. You can't think it, he will do it, because he is the supernatural God. He is the unlimited God. And John, in the revelation that we have read from, I'll get there in a minute, he says this message of Jesus Christ must be preached in all the churches. Tell all the churches about Jesus, who is the Alpha and the Omega. Tell them about Jesus, who is the beginning and who is the end. Tell them about Jesus, who is able, amen, to lift them up from where they are and to place them in a place of peace and prosperity, protection, and give them his pardon. Tell them about Jesus Christ, who is the first and the last. Somebody praise him with me there. Wave your hand and say something there. I feel I'm going to preach to somebody here today. Oh, glory. Hallelujah. Jude says that Jesus is the only one that can keep us from falling and also to present us faultless before the presence of his Father's glory. To him be glory, honor, majesty, dominion, and power both now and forever. He's the only one who can keep us from falling. Tell your neighbor, God can keep you. Tell them like you mean it from the depth of your heart. Hallelujah. God can keep you from falling in this sinful world, in this world of misery and strife, where everywhere you turn, sin is on every hand. Turn on your television screen, sin stares you in the face. Walk in the community, sin is staring you in the face. At the workplace, sin is staring you. In the streets, sin is everywhere you go. Sin is on every hand. But God can keep us from falling to the devil's level. And not only that, he'll keep us from falling, but when all is said and done, he will present us faultless before the presence of his Father's glory. Dear God, if you didn't shout for that, you miss the greatest part of this service, a shout. Think of who we were, think of who we are, and to know that when that day comes, through the precious blood of Jesus Christ, he's going to present us faultless, sinless, cleansed, washed, purified before the presence of his Father's glory, and say, here are they, my Father. These are they who have been washed in my blood, and because of my blood, they are faultless, because I took their infirmity. I paid the price for them. I drank the bitter cup for them. I took the 39 stripes on my back for them. I went to Calvary for them. I took the nails in my hands. I took the nails in my feet. I bore the crown of thorn on my head. I took the spear in my side. I spent 3 days and night in hell to fight against their enemy. And I came up from hell declaring, I am he that liveth and was dead. Behold, I'm alive forevermore. And I brought with me the keys. Somebody shout something here. I brought with me the keys of death and hell. And I open every door that Satan closed on them. Somebody praise God. Hallelujah. Some of you got some doors that name and close in your face. And those doors need to be opened. cannot tell you this morning that if you reach out by faith in the name of Jesus, the Holy Ghost will release a key in your spirit. I did not say a key in your hand. This is not physical. I said a key in your spirit, and you will reach out by faith in the name of Jesus and open up a door to your blessing, open up a door to your prosperity, open up a door to your healing, open up a door to your financial blessing, open up a door to a successful marriage, open up a door. And when the Holy Ghost opens that door, somebody shout, no man. Shout, no man. Say, no woman. Say, no boy. Say, no girl. Nobody can close. Echo Moshataba. Somebody better praise him here. Because I'm telling you about Jesus, God's complete package for mankind. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. My God. All right, let's settle it down a little. You need to tax down the runway before you take off, man. Not only what John says, not only what Jude says, but Brother Luke says, Dr. Luke says, Jesus is the only Savior. The only Savior. For neither is there salvation in any other. Acts chapter 4 and verse 12. For there is none other name under heaven given among men whereby, wherewith we can be saved but at the name of Jesus. When the angel proclaimed him in Matthew chapter 1 and verse 21, the angel declared, you shall call his name Jesus, for he shall save his people from their sin. Somebody praise him with me. Somebody need a change of life. What you need is salvation of Jesus Christ. When you get that salvation, it fixes you up from your head to your toes. One songwriter puts it this way, it soothes your sorrow, it heals your wounds, and it drives away all of your fears. Give him praise. So he's the only Savior. And Jesus himself declared in no uncertain way, he says, all those who came before me were liars and thieves and robbers, imposters who had nothing to offer. Amen. They were wolves in sheep clothing. Do you not know that we have some such persons around today? Hallelujah. They were there, they are here, and they will be here until Jesus returns. But I'm glad there's a difference between the blood-bought child of God and those who just join a church. If you just join a church, the devil can run you from church to church, from religion to religion, from denomination to denomination. Can I preach something here this morning? But when you are born in the body of Christ, washed in the blood of Jesus, saved and sanctified, sealed with the Holy Ghost, no devil trace you around the place. You become the devil's driver because you have power in the name of Jesus to chase the devil out of town. Somebody say something here. I believe the church must get radical. Hallelujah. And get together and chase the devil out of town. Put him out of business from among the prayer matters. Put him out of business from among the preachers. Put him out of business from among choir members. Put him him out of business from among church people. Let him know we are the head and not the tail. We are above and not beneath. Somebody praise God in this house. Hallelujah. Those who feel like a victor, just shake your body, shake your shoulder. Whatever you can shake, shake something in the name of Jesus. And let the devil know something is inside of you. Some of you got Jeremiah's fire. Shakotobohoya. Hey, when you got Jesus, you got power to run through your troop. You got power to leap over your wall. You got power to bind him under your feet. Hey, yo. My God Almighty. Woo! Sit down, please. So John, in the book of Revelation, oh hallelujah, he describes this Jesus in so many ways, and he proclaimed him so wonderfully. And he said, those who read concerning this Jesus must believe the prophecy, amen, of the things that are written therein, for the time is at hand. Tell somebody, the time is at hand. Hallelujah. In verse 5, he said, Jesus Christ is the faithful witness and the first begotten of the dead and the prince of the kings of the earth. Unto him who loved us and washed us from our sins in his own blood. Somebody praise him with me. The faithful witness. Somebody say, faithful witness. Not little try and test. The devil tried and tested him. Hallelujah. We are right in this season now where Satan threw all kinds of darts at him. Showed him the kingdoms of the world. Amen. Tell him to turn stones into bread. Or throw himself down from the mountain, because God will protect him. The devil is a deceiver. When he doesn't come with a lie, he comes with a deception. Are you with me, somebody? But we are not ignorant of his devices. We know his strategies because we have the Holy Ghost. God Almighty. Somebody say something there. Hallelujah. Not only that, but in verse 6, he has made us kings and priests unto God and his Father, and to him again be glory and dominion forever and ever. John say amen. Somebody shout amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. What is written in this book concerning this Jesus of Nazareth is something that every believer should hold on to very dear. Because he is the first and the last, and he is the in-between. Come on, somebody. So as we journey along life's pathway, facing all the tribulations and all the things that come against us as believers, because believe me, yes or no, and I believe you will, these last days are throwing all kinds of hell against the believers. Some things that are happening now, they have never happened before. Come on, somebody. God says, behold, I will do a new thing, Isaiah 19, whatever. And the devil seemed to be doing his new thing. His new thing, or one of his new thing, it seemed to be a strategy to destroy the future. Destroy our children. We have never seen the kind of barbarous acts and the kind of heinous crimes, atrocity of the highest order being done against the innocent ones in this nation. Young girls and young boys. Satan tried to kill them through Herod, but he could not kill Jesus. Am I talking to somebody? Pharaoh tried to kill them and kill Moses, but he could not. But in the name of Jesus Christ, we are going to lift up a standard. And I want every born again child of God to raise your right hand and lift your palm in Jesus' name and say, devil, you must stop. Say, devil, you must stop. In the name of Jesus, you must stop. You must stop. You will not destroy our children, our sons, our daughters, grandson, granddaughters. We bind you in the name of Jesus. Shekobo Samaha. Somebody release. Release from your spirit something in the domain of principalities and power. And say, back up sex demon. Back up murder demon. Back up killing spirit. Back up incestuous spirit. Back up. Back off. Back up. Back off. The blood of Jesus is against you. Shekobo Sabaha. Somebody lift your hand and plead the blood. Plead the blood in Kingston, in St. Andrew, in St. Catherine, in Clarendon, in Manchester, in St. Elizabeth, in Trelawney, in St. James, in St. Thomas, in St. Mary, in Hanover, in Trelawney. Plead the blood of Jesus against. Woo! Sit down, please. Dear God, I feel the power of the Holy Ghost. God's package. Complete package. Everything and more package. What is it that he cannot do for you today? Is there anything too hard for God? What is it that he cannot do for you? The question was asked of Abraham many years ago, is anything too hard for God? Is there anything that he cannot do? He saves, he heals, he delivers, he blesses, he supplies our needs, he opens up doors for us, he sets men free, he gives us divine favor. Oh, bless the name of Jesus, and much more. He's bigger than all, bigger than everything. The heaven of heavens cannot contain him. Someone would say he's so high you can't get over him. He's so low you can't get underneath him. He's so wide you can't get around him. Bow your knees to him and say, Lord, I surrender. He's bigger than the sun. S-U-N. It's bigger than the moon. It's bigger than the stars. It's bigger than all the planets comprise this universe and beyond. Bigger than Mercury. Bigger than Venus. Bigger than Earth. Bigger than Mars. Bigger than Jupiter. Bigger than Saturn. Bigger than Uranus. Bigger than Neptune. He is bigger than them all. He created them for his glory. Hallelujah. Not only that, he's bigger than them. But yes, he controls the asteroid belt. Everything that is out of space. Where man tried to go. Amen. In spaceship. I don't care how far they are able to go. Jesus is still bigger than where they can reach. Because he controls the entire asterized belt of this universe. He has them in the palm of his hands. Aren't you glad he is your Savior? Aren't you glad he is your Lord? Aren't you glad he is your soon coming King? Aren't you glad for God's package and more, which is Jesus Christ?
Oh, glory. Give him praise, somebody. So wave your hand and say something there. So John says to tell everybody from Jesus Christ. Amen. I, John, verse 9, Revelation 1. I, John, who am your brother and companion in tribulation and in the kingdom and in patience of Jesus Christ, was in the isle that is called Patmos for the word of God and for the testimony of Jesus Christ. He was thrown there because he stood up as a firm believer. He was thrown there because they wanted him to deny Christ, to amen, to compromise his faith. But John said, for me to live is Christ and to die is gain. I'd rather die with my testimony. Somebody praise him with me. And that is what many of our brothers and sisters this very moment in other parts of the world are facing. They are facing it in Syria. They are facing it in Iraq. They are facing it in Tunisia. They are facing it all over the world. Persecution. Amen. I learned the other day the minority Christians in a certain country, I'll leave nameless, are under tremendous persecution for their faith, because these are the end times. They might be facing those kinds of tribulation in other parts of the world, but we in the Western world, we are facing another type of tribulation. Another type. One that the devil brings in our living room, brings in our bedroom, brings it in the church, in our pockets, and in our gadgets. Am I talking to anybody here? Control the minds of the children. Almost every child you see these days walking around have some gadget going through or something in their ears listening to. And my God, if you check it out, they're not listening to gospel songs. They are not listening to scripture reading. They are not listening to messages. They are listening to things from another world. Am I preaching to anybody here? And this invasion of evil from the pit of hell has come down upon us. And when it is not in cyberspace and through those gadgets, it is true. Amen. The amen. Worldly allurement. The things of the world capture us with the lust of the flesh, with the lust of the eyes, with the pride of life. And everybody wants to get everything and get them now. At any cost, they want to get everything now. And because of that, more thieves and criminals are on the rise. More con artists are on the rise. More bandoloists are on the rise. More corruption is on the rise. Can I preach to anybody here? Because the enemy has found many strategies to defeat the body of Christ. But Jesus declared many years ago upon this rock. Somebody tamp your right foot and say the rock. Tamp your left foot and say the rock. Upon this rock. Jesus said, I build my church, and the gates of hell shall not prevail against it. Amen. The devil will fight, but he's fighting a losing battle. All those who know that the devil is fighting a losing battle against you, against you, against you, lift your hand and say, losing battle. Shake your hand and say, losing battle. If you know he's fighting a losing battle against you, say in the name of Jesus, losing battle, losing battle. You can't win in Jesus' name. Maketo Sabaha. Woo! Thank you, Jesus. So for his testimony, he was thrown in the Isles of Patmos. Amen. Historical records said they dug a hole, deep hole, and they put John down in there. And they mold him up to his neck. And they pour oil on him. Oil on his neck, on his head, to his shoulder. You know what that means? It would attract all of the insects to come and eat him little by little by little by little alive. But it was then the Spirit of the Lord came upon him. I was in the Spirit on the Lord's day. I feel the Holy Ghost. And I heard a voice from heaven. The voice said, I am Alpha. I am Omega. I'm the beginning. I am the ending. I am the first. I am the last. John, I'm going to get you out of here because you got a message for the nation. You got a story to tell. I got to get you out of this Isle of Patmos situation. No animals will eat you. God has a way to deliver his people. Some of you, my God, are in some situation today. And the devil tells you he's going to kill you right there. But he's a liar. In the name of Jesus, you come out of many before, and you're coming out of this one. You come out of many before, and you're coming out of this one. Say, I'm coming out of this one. Coming out of this one. Coming out of this one. It will not. Makotabaha. Hallelujah. He did it before. He'll do it again. Wave your hand and say something in this house. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You got a message to the churches, John. So you will not die in the Isle of Patmos. I declare in the name of Jesus Christ that you will not die in that present situation. God is going to take you out with a testimony of victory. My God Almighty, wave your hand in this anointing. I said, wave your hand in this anointing. Let's finish this thing. Not only John declared him, but I can't close this message without tell you something about my good friend Isaiah. Everybody say Isaiah. Because in chapter 9, Isaiah said some things concerning God's package, Messiah, Jesus Christ. Somebody shout a praise down there. Thank you, Jesus. Isaiah said, nevertheless, the dimness shall not be as such as was in her vexation. When at the first he lightly afflicted the land of Zebulun and the land of Naphtali, and afterward did more grievously afflict her by the way of the sea, beyond Jordan, in Galilee, amen, of the nations. The people that walk in darkness have seen a great light, and they that dwell in the land of the shadow of death, upon them hath the light shine. Thou hast multiplied the nation, and not increased the joy. They joy before thee according to the joy in harvest, as men rejoice when they divide the spoil. For thou hast broken the yoke of his burden, and the staff of his shoulder, and the rod of his oppressor, as in the day of Midian. For every battle of the warrior is with confused noise, and garments rolled in blood. But this shall be with burning and fuel of fire. Why? For unto us, lift your hand and say, unto us. Tell your neighbor, unto us. Tell them, unto us. I mean all of us.
I mean, who all are we? Unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given, and the government shall be upon his shoulder, God Almighty, and his name shall be called Wonderful Counselor, the Mighty God, the Everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace. And of the increase of his government and peace, there shall be no end upon the throne of David and upon the kingdom, to order it and to establish it with righteousness and judgment. Somebody praise God here. Devil can't stop it. I said devil can't stop it. PNP can't stop it. JLP can't stop it. WPJ can't stop it. And all the other P's can't stop it. Republican can't stop it. Democrats can't stop it. Communists can't stop it. Atheists can't stop it. Agnostics can't stop it. Infidel can't stop it. And guess what? You can't stop it. You can't stop the church of the living God. Somebody praise him here. Hey, the government shall rest upon his shoulder. I feel I'm preaching to somebody. Hallelujah. So it's not just a child born, a son given. He presents the one on whose shoulder the governments of the world rest. Tell the most powerful presidents of the world that he doesn't run things. He should be coming to Jamaica based on what we heard. And we bless God for him, at first African American to ascend to that high office. But let him know there's a higher power. Are you not saying nothing in this place? Hallelujah. Let him know there's a higher power. Let Sister P knows that there's a higher power. Let Brother Hunter know that there's a higher power. All their predecessors know that there is a higher power, and they too will know. Oh God, can I preach for 5 more minutes here? The government shall be upon his shoulder, and his rule shall have no end. You can't vote him in. You can't vote him out. You cannot impeach him. You cannot demonstrate against him. You can't block road and stop him. You can't burn tire and stop him. You can't light the dump and stop him. You can't have gas strike and stop him. You can't lock down the airport and stop him. You can't close the seaport and stop him. He is Lord. God, why not somebody praise God in this house? Jesus Christ is God's package and more. Yeah. Oh yeah. Jesus, the everything and more package. He does everything, and he can do more. Somebody praise him here. Hallelujah. He is God. He's your eternal comforter. He's your redeemer. He's your savior. And he gives you good success to be obedient to him, is to receive the fullness of his blessing. For if you be willing and obedient, you shall eat the good of the land. But if you refuse and rebel, you'll be devoured of the sword. For the mouth of the Lord has spoken it. What is it that you want him to do for you? What is it that you think he cannot do for you? Over the side, what is it that you think he cannot do? Some folks telling you all kind of junk. God can't do this. God can't do that. He's able to do exceeding abundantly above all that you may ask, all that you may think, according to his mighty power. When you have that package, I have everything I need to make me happy. Stand with me, everybody, please. I've got Jesus to show me the way. Every unsaved, he has saved me. The altar is open. Gave me life eternal. You need God's package. Make your way. And now I am everything. Somebody lift your hand and sing it again. I want to pray for every unsaved, every backslider, everyone that needs Jesus. Everybody sick and discouraged and weak. Up your hands and close your eyes and see it out.
I have everything I need to make me happy.
My God Almighty, I feel the presence of God.
I have Jesus to show me the way.
Come and receive God's package.
He has saved me.
Give it up, lady, yes. Give it up. Give it up. Give it up. Give it up. Give it up.
hands, everybody. Close your eyes and begin to worship God. Come on. No holds barred. Don't hold back on nothing. This is a moment for you to touch the hem of his garment. Yeah, go right ahead and worship him right in the prayer. Come on, don't you hold back nothing. Don't you hold back nothing. Take this package this morning. Take Jesus. Take Jesus. Take Jesus. Everybody enter into prayer.
To God, we cry out to you today, Jesus. We come to you, Father. No other help we know but you, Jesus. If you do not stretch your hands to us, Father, where will we go, Jesus? Here we cry out to you, mighty God. We thank you, mighty God, that you shed your blood for us, Jesus, that we could come to you like this, Jesus. So here we are, mighty God, kneeling before your presence, mighty God. Our hearts broken, our spirits lifted to you, mighty God, crying out to you, Father, for you to help, Jesus. We cry out to you, help, Father. Help, Abba, Father. We need you, Jesus. Our world is wretched, mighty God, broken into pieces, mighty God. But you are the divine potter, mighty God, and you have your hands on the world, mighty God. So here we are, mighty God, asking you to put us on your wheel even one more time, mighty God, to mold us back into shape, mighty God. Some of us have been broken by circumstances, mighty God, weakened by disease, mighty God, crippled by situations, mighty God, but here we are crying out to you one more time, Jesus, saying, put us back on that wheel, mighty God. Put your hands on us one more time, mighty God, and mold us back into shape, mighty God. We are vessels of honor, mighty God, and we have lost your way, mighty God, but here we are crying out to you, Father, finding our way back to the foot of the cross today, Jesus. And we cry out to you today, mighty God. You cannot fail, mighty God. And you are a God of your word. You honor your word above your name, mighty God. You said you not cause any of the sickness that would have come upon the Egyptians to come upon your people, mighty God. And some of us are afflicted today, mighty God, bound by so many chains of life, mighty God. But you are the chain breaker this morning. You will loose fetters this morning, mighty God. We know when your presence comes in, mighty God, you will loose your people. You will set us free from whatever bondage, mighty God. So we come to you, Father, even right now, knowing that you are our all-sufficient God, mighty God. You are our provider this morning, our healer, our all-in-all this morning, mighty God. And we humble ourselves in awe of your awesome power this morning, mighty God. Rain down your spirit upon your people this morning, Jesus. Rain down, mighty God. Set your fire, mighty God, to walk through this place even right now, mighty God. And burn out iniquity in the name of Jesus. Jesus, we ask you even right now, mighty God. You understand our individual needs even right now, mighty God. Even as we cry out to you, mighty God, you know us by name and by number, mighty God. But your blood is sufficient, mighty God, to heal every wound, mighty God. You were wounded for our transgressions, bruised for our iniquities, mighty God. The chastisement for peace was upon him, and by your stripes, mighty God, we believe it by faith. We declare it, mighty God, that we are healed, mighty God. So we thank you, Jesus.
My God, lift up your hands and give him praise. Come on. Come on, open up your mouth. And I don't know why you don't want to praise him. Hallelujah. In the mighty name of Jesus. Yeah, hallelujah. Rise and be healed in the name of Jesus. Hold your neighbor's hand right now.
Let faith your soul. Rise and rise and be. Come on, get up in the name of Jesus and be healed. Let faith arise in your soul. Rise up and be healed in Jesus' name.
In the name,
be healed
of Jesus.
Of every infirmity,
he will cleanse you, and then you are.
By the authority of Jesus Christ, the shed blood of Calvary, the power of the Holy Ghost, we release the healing virtue of Almighty God to flow in this congregation, television, radio, internet. My brother, my sister, we rebuke the condition of sickness in your body. The blood of Jesus Christ is against it. Cut it out, Holy Ghost, and raise up your people. Deliver them from those attacks of the enemy. Satan, we put you under our feet. In the name of Jesus, we will not be subject to any of your disease and your attack from hell. The blood is against you. Be healed from the crown of your head to the soles of your feet. Every chronic condition, the blood is against you now. Come out in Jesus' name. Come out of the head. Come out of the ears. Come out of the eyes. Come out of the neck. Come out of the stomach. Come out of the breast. Come out of the womb. Come out of the hands. Come out in Jesus' name. Come out. Be healed. Be healed in Jesus' name. My God Almighty, come out of the feet. Come out, devil. The blood is against you. Maleko Shabahoda. Shetekoraba Usata. Randa Baba Kesekotaya. Rusiteke moho. Eyakora Hushama Heye. Rasatabaha. Be healed. And set free. Jesus' name. My God, clap your hands and shout the victory. I didn't say meditate the victory, I said shout the victory. I didn't say whisper the victory, I said shout the victory.